How about this, guys?
Yeah.
I know what I'm fucking sick of seeing.
Uh-oh.
Sick of seeing reaction videos. I'm tired of them.
Yeah.
I'm fucking done with reaction videos.
Okay.
And it's always...
You're talking about porn reaction videos, right?
No.
Oh, okay.
Talk about reaction videos, and it's always the same fucking formula. The guy's lighting up fireworks!
Stop lighting up fireworks, guy. Yep. Down the street.
I have to shut my window. But anyway, it's always the same format. Always the same thing. It's 90% of the time, they make some black person watch a video that is typically white music.
So yeah.
It's like... Hip hop head reacts to fucking anything, Cannibal Corpse, and hip hop head reacts to, like, it's like, guys, man, and then they got to, like, stand up. Oh, man, I like that breakdown. It's cool that they're exposing these guys to good music, but it's just getting tired. You know, it's like over and over again, you always see it like, or Christian reacts to Slayer. Do you guys see that one?
No, that's all.
It's like it's like these two Christian couple.
Is it a black guy and a white girl?
Yeah, it's interracial, yeah. And they make them react to all this satanic music,
right?
And see what they think.
I'm gonna have to watch that one.
I just shared a link to them with Ben, on a video that they did reacting to Her Ghost in the Fog, Cradle of Filth, and see now, I actually enjoy. Okay, so there are certain reaction videos that I can kind of get something out of. I thought the one they did with Cradle of Filth was kind of interesting, cute, whatever, you know. Neckbone happened to think that it was completely satire. But anyway, so the music ones can be hit or miss. There's one chick that's like a vocal coach that does a lot of reaction videos to like various rock singers or whatever, and it's interesting to hear a professional's input on like these kind of off the wall singers. That can be what I don't like is like these cheap, lazy. There's like a lot of YouTubers like, watch me react to the Red Wedding, watch me react to fucking the Sonic trailer. And it's like, you know, they've already seen it. Okay. They've probably rehearsed their reaction. I don't know how many fucking times. And even if they didn't, that's the laziest shit you can do for a YouTube video. Right. Right. You know what? I think here's the divide. One, it is a YouTuber who is doing their own reaction video to Take Your Pick, whatever it is. Right. I'm very cynical about that. I don't believe that their reaction is genuine. Now, when it's like, I saw some fucking video that I thought I got a real kick out of, which was they took all these old people and had them play through the prologue for The Last of Us. They just took these old people and said, hey, here's this game. They don't play games. They take these random people and place them in this situation.
Yeah.
Right. And it's a genuine reaction. And it's very interesting to see like this generation of people that are in no way at all.
Yeah. They're, you know, ready they're not fans for this. Of this. They're not
so
ready.
That can be interesting. There's those videos that, especially, you know, with Game of Thrones episode 3 when the Night King got killed. Spoiler alert if you fucking haven't seen it. Yeah. Like there are those reaction videos where they pan around like a bar, right? Where it's like 150 people watching it, right?
Yeah.
Live. That can be kind of neat. But again, when it's just like that sole YouTuber putting that out as like content, I think it's lazy and annoying.
Because me, especially even with like pictures and stuff, I prefer something that's candid, something you're not expecting. To me, that's the best reaction you get from anything. So like if I take pictures of the kids, I like to do it. I don't like to set them up and say, hey, everybody stand right here and wait, and then everybody say cheese. I'd rather just take a candid picture of people. To me, that's better than, it's more real.
Absolutely.
So something like that, like the bar thing where people don't know what's going to happen, I like that. But yeah, like you were saying with the people who have rehearsed the reaction, especially if somebody who makes original content on YouTube, something that's that staged and that fake would probably piss me off to the extent.
Yeah,
too.
I mean, I'm in like a few different like small YouTubers groups, as I've mentioned before, being a small YouTuber myself. And so it goes without saying that a lot of the links that get posted are people, hey, check out my video. Hey, check out my video. Hey, check out my video. That's what we all do. And there is a sizable portion of these creators that's their thing. That's their shtick. It's gaming and reaction videos. And those are the two laziest fucking things you can do. Now, if you're an amazing gamer and you have great insight and pro tips and stuff, that's fine. Most of them are just fucking
watch me
half-ass my way through fucking Dark Souls like a fucking idiot.
I will add one other form of the media to it, and that's unboxing videos.
Yes.
Is the point of that shit?
Well, it's a reaction video. It's the same thing.
It's just
look at this.
It's that, and then they try it's just as you guys describe, but like I was saying, they always try to take someone. This guy isn't the type of person that likes this type of the thing. Let's watch him react to it.
It goes back to what we just said a minute ago. I don't mind it if it's something that is candid and it's not necessarily set up that way.
Or it's genuinely interesting. Like some hip hop guy making him listen to death metal 1 week, black metal the next week, grindcore the next week. It's like, okay, it's a shtick.
Especially if it's the same guy.
Yeah, who cares?
The one guy really did like Domination, that black guy. That breakdown, he dug it.
Yeah.
I mean, it can be cool. I would say that I would agree with you to an extent and disagree with you to an extent. You know, reaction videos are lazy, but they're sometimes those types of videos, you know, especially with music, can be mildly entertaining to me.
I'm going
to